of potential patients.
The patient they've identified is a man in his 50s. He's here because he has a long-term lung condition. He's typical of the sort of patient that would benefit from being cared for at home. And crucially, it means for the hospital, they have a bed free for somebody else.
Hi, Richard. Yes, are you all right?
Richard has a chronic long-term lung condition. He was admitted last week, but is desperate to go home.
It's coming up to Christmas. It's really, all my heating and everything's on in my flat as well. So I'm burning electric at the minute. I need to get home and sort things out for Christmas, really. So, yeah, it means everything to me.
Richard will become a patient on a virtual ward. His health will be monitored remotely by staff at the hospital. The shortage of beds puts pressure on every part of the hospital, including its emergency department.
This gives us a snapshot of the scale of the demand on emergency services. So right now, outside the A&E, we have 10 ambulances waiting. The longest ambulance has been waiting just over 3 hours. Now, across the region, there's 436 patients who require an ambulance, 73 in our local area, and we can see the wait times just on there. Some people have been waiting a very long time.
If beds can't be found, ambulances can't hand over sick patients.
5 years ago, you wouldn't come to emergency departments, be seen, need a bed, and then wait several hours for that bed. That wouldn't happen. We would have considered that to be unacceptable, and that's now a daily occurrence.
It was here exactly 2 years ago that the world's first COVID vaccine was administered. It changed the course of the pandemic. That health crisis also forced change on the NHS, like the virtual ward that will now let Richard go home early. Our health service will need more innovation if it's to cope with a winter that's coming. Ashish Joshi, Sky News, in Coventry.